S-T-A-L-K-I-N-G. There was a guy named Tom, age 14, who had a major crush on a girl named Maxine, age 17, and she was a cheerleader. He really wanted to please her by giving her letters, saying hi. But he had one flaw, he was completely shy. But Maxine accepted the letters she received, and some of Tom's friends were not even angry like Rick James. It was fire and desire, causing Tom to become Maxine's secret admirer when nobody else had to know. In other words, he had to keep it on the down low. He wrote a lot of poems expressing his feelings, trying so hard to make the situation appealing. He even had a couple of dreams of receiving a first kiss on the lips from Maxine. But little did Tom knew, she was a senior, preparing to leave high school, and she's focused on someone her age. And the drama began, not in a couple of days, but months. But I'll save that for verse number two. For some of you don't have a clue, that's why I'm singing this song. Correct me if I'm wrong, stalking must die and my word is bond. Around 3 months later, drama started to arrive. Thomas over the top with his disguise, and that's when he did the most redundant things, like look up her address and giving her some change. Maxine received $20 a week, and that's when she had no other choice but to speak. She told her friends that someone's scaring her for a while, and one of Tom's friends didn't even smile, because he discovered why Maxine was miserable, and he told her who done it. And he later told Maxine's crew, along with Tom's other friends, to meet up with Tom and put this creepy behavior to an end. On Tuesday, Tom was going to his locker, but everyone surrounded him, calling him a stalker, and Tom's friends were mad, yelling at him, while Maxine's friends started exposing him. And a piece of paper was given, a letter from Maxine, who was afraid of him, asking Tom to leave her alone. She sent to 17-year-old boys, and Tom should have known, which led him to falling on his knees. And everybody mad at him started to leave. He was a jerk all along, he knew he was wrong. Stalking must die, and my word is bond. After a couple of months alone and ashamed, the entire school threw dirt on his name. But Tom was not gonna let that slide, for he was making things right and stopped acting shy. He found Maxine still hurt, but told her the truth in person, for what it's worth, where an apology was required. He even admitted that he was her secret admirer, and the school got quiet. He walked off, and some individuals started crying. Since he had no friends, he walked outside the door, got on his knees and prayed to the Lord. He paid more attention to school than any other girl, because he lusted, and there's no way in the world that Tom would do that ever again. He even showed up to Maxine's graduation to support her, as a real friends would do. But he didn't turn back after graduation was through. However, Maxine ran to Tommy with tears in her eyes, and they started hugging for 30 seconds, the longest hug. And for she forgave him for what he had done. And I conclude the song, you know what's going on, stalking must die, and my word is bond. To all stalkers everywhere, don't get involved. And you know it's wrong, don't get involved. And if you did it and somebody is mad at you, letting you know from parent to friends and everybody else, you got to make the right decision and apologize. Because when it comes to stalking, you're going too far. Really far. Why am I telling you all this? Because I've been responsible for doing that myself. And this is not what everybody wants, so please take this lesson from me and stop this madness. For stalking must die, and my word is gone.